Hey everyone. So I'm currently about 10 weeks out from the next competition that I'm doing, which is going to be the USAPL Minnesota State Meet for men. But I'm just going to kind of go over some of the things with you about like what I'm going to be doing to improve my bench press. And as you see here, this is kind of like a video of my most recent meet. Of my lifting, of my current bench press technique, setup, and all that. Now, generally, you don't have to arch as high as mine. You know what I mean? This is pretty much just going to be an explanation of some of the weaknesses with my technique and form and strength at the moment, and what I plan on doing, and why I'm doing these things to kind of give you all an idea of what you could be doing for your own technique and your own bench press. You know, like even if you don't plan on competing in a powerlifting meet, some of these ideas would just be good for your personal self to increase strength, increase muscle, and all that good stuff. All right. Okay, so let's review my third attempt bench press. So as you watch, right when the bar comes off my chest, which is like maybe an inch or two off my chest, the bar stops. And when the bar stops, I'm having to use more leg drive on the floor than I should, and I'm in a very awkward position to drive my legs because now I'm like just honestly the weight is just too heavy. So I'm trying to get more power from my legs to kind of help drive up, but it's not there, so my butt comes off. And my lats are kind of out of the movement now, so technically I'm not going to be able to push it anymore, and it's a red light no matter what. So the question that I have to ask is, what do I have to do from this point on in order to move 325 pounds from the point that it is stuck here all the way to lockout with my butt on the bench? This is a new technique that I've been working on where my feet is a little bit more pointed out, kind of similar to like my sumo or squat stance. I'm trying to get more comfortable with that versus having my feet closer towards the bench. So that's been kind of feeling a little bit awkward, and 325 pounds didn't feel heavy. I just couldn't press it with the technique that I have now because it hasn't solidified yet. So I'm going to be doing a lot of technique work in order to kind of fix this problem. I'm probably going to be adding some overload methods to kind of help force some heavier weights around this point that I'm stuck at, and a couple of weird exercises that I'm going to show you in my next 10 or so weeks and hope during the time that I do bench press, let's say 325 or maybe a little bit more, depending on how training goes at the meet in February. And maybe you could use some of these techniques or ideas into your own training and see how well all of that kind of works together. All right, so for day one, I chose the banded bench press. I really like the way the bands pull down on the weight, so it really forces you to stay really tight, especially on your upper back and your core. And as you drive the weight away, the band's gonna pull down, and you really have to squeeze the bar hard on top of force your butt onto the bench. So this is a very light variation that I'm gonna be doing every week on day one to kind of work on solidifying my current technique right now, and to make sure I can really stay tight. And I don't really want to be going too heavy with the weight. Because this is going to be just like again like a lighter variation to kind of really hone down my technique for the next 10 weeks. So going light will also ensure that I don't overtrain or overwork myself. Okay, so for day two, the next exercise that I'm going to be focusing on for the week would be the dead bench press. Pretty much what I'm doing is I'm setting the safety pins right where it's about an inch and a half away from me, pretty much where I got stuck at before. And I'm pretty much just adding a lot of weight because there's no way I'm gonna get hurt doing this exercise because the safety pins are already catching the weight. So I'm gonna pretty much just try to put on as much weight as I can around this area and really press that weight away from me. And as I'm doing that, I really wanna feel my lats underneath the bar as I press. And I really want to feel my glutes and my leg drive pushing down on the floor as I drive up. So this is going to be really working on that little weakness of mine. So if I'm already doing 315 now, hopefully, you know, do some more exercise, some more work with this exercise. Maybe it might help me with my bench press at the competition. But then again, utilizing this technique of doing where I'm resetting every single time kind of helps force myself to always work on technique and always force myself to find the best position when I'm at the bottom. So hopefully when I do get 325 or more in that same spot, it will just drive all the way through versus get stuck like before. Okay, and then on top of that, once I'm done with all that, pretty much just, you know, some incline dumbbell presses, flat dumbbell presses with dumbbell rows. The reason why I really like the dumbbells is because it's not a barbell, so it doesn't spread across my chest. I can angle the dumbbell a little bit better. Really like the incline dumbbell press because that's kind of what you're trying to do when you lock out a bench press. You know, you're kind of bringing it halfway up and halfway back, and the incline dumbbell presses really help train the halfway back part. And then, of course, I really like to do flat dumbbell presses as well. You know, going fairly heavy on the dumbbell presses, you know, anywhere between, you know, 8 to 15 reps, you know, going as heavy as you can for those reps really help you work on your grip strength, especially when you go back to barbell stuff. And then, obviously, the dumbbell rows is just a reverse of that movement to really help me lock in and engage my lats as I'm bench pressing. So these are really good exercises to add into your accessories. On top of all that is, again, you know, doing any more exercises for your upper back. So, like, this is where I like to do my heavy pull-up days, where I kind of do a pull-up after every superset or every exercise of any accessory that I'm doing. On top of, you know, working on my grip. You know, when you get a stronger grip, your bench press is always going to feel a little bit better. So, again, adding face pulls, you know, more emphasis on not much so much the weight, but just controlling my back, really feeling how the muscles feel and really squeeze. You know, adding extra chest exercises here and there, like the dips and stuff like that. And honestly, today is kind of like the accessory or fun day, and you can kind of add whatever it is that you want and just do as much as you can with the amount of time that you have for that day. And of course, any, you know, my issues is locking out, so training arms, training triceps, training biceps, doing curls with a thicker bar, so my fingers have to squeeze to really hone in to all the weaknesses that I have with my current bench presses. All right, so for day three, on top of my top sets of my bench presses, I like to add a slingshot, or pretty much kind of like a knee wrap, but for your bench press. Pretty much what it does is it pulls down on your chest a little bit more, and you can put on a little bit more weight on the bar with less pressure on your shoulders. And I like to use this as an overload on top of what I'm already doing with my regular bench press. I won't be as taxing because the bench buddy or the slingshot that I have on currently kind of allows me to hold on to heavier weight with less consequences. And I like to use this to kind of help me get ready for the next week's weight. On top of, once all that's done with the, you know, slingshot work, I like to add negatives. I like to pretty much control the weight down as much as I can to my chest for about 6 to 8 seconds, and then kind of hold at the very bottom for about 1 or 2 seconds to mimic a real bench press. And that's all I'm doing, just focusing on controlling the weight, kind of doing like a row, pulling the bar onto me, getting a nice pause, holding it there and staying as tight as I can, and then release. Okay, so far I've had a medium heavy day, a light day after the medium day, and then the heaviest day the previous day. And today's just going to be another light day that I'm adding. So I'm doing floor presses. I'm doing pretty much like half of a press, not a full press, so I don't overwork that range of motion for my bench press. And this exercise right here, the floor presses, I'm moving my fingers about 3 fingers in. So if you watch, that's my grip, and then I move 1, 2, 3, and that's where I usually grip the bar. Floor presses is really good because it focuses on really squeezing that upper back and controlling the bar as it comes down. If you don't control the bar as it comes down, your elbow's gonna bang the floor, and you don't want that. So what you're really gonna do as you bring the bar down is be careful, squeeze the bar, squeeze the triceps, lock it in place. And this really helps that pause when you do like a bench press in a real competition. And then honestly, today is just another day where you add lighter exercises that help benefit your bench press. So like do like bent over rows, you know, you could do triceps, biceps, more shoulder work, and all these other exercises.